Mark Steyn, R.S. Field tweets into you if you would talk a bit about George MacDonald Fraser and why he was an influence.
Well, I think this was on my favorite authors
favorites
or favorite
list,
books.
Right, that we
yeah.
just showed.
What I love about him is George MacDonald Fraser, for people who don't know, is he's the author of the Flashman books. About 40 years ago, the late 60s, he got the inspired idea to take a minor character in the 19th century novel Tom Brown's Schoolboys, the bully, and make him the central figure in what was essentially a history of the British Empire up to the early 20th century. In other words, George MacDonald Fraser inserted Flashman into the First Afghan War, and I think actually in one novel into the U.S. Civil War, and into Madagascar, where he winds up having sex with the most notorious queen of Madagascar, and all the rest of it. So he did a Forrest Gump type of thing, in that he inserted this character of his into all these real life situations. P.G. Woodhouse loved that series. He read the first book and he said something like, it was, you know, the great sigh of contentment when you know that a series is being born and you're going to love it, love every one of them. But what I learned about that, and the reason I like him, is because after the Afghan invasion, when everyone was suddenly an expert on Afghan, oh, graveyard of empire, Pashtuns, Uzbeks, you know, they're all suddenly the dancing boys of Kandahar. Everyone's an expert on Afghanistan, and I loved going back and reading, which I hadn't done since I was at school, reading George MacDonald Fraser's first Flashman book, where Flashman winds up, and almost, as I think of it, particularly after 10 long years, 10 thankless years in the Hindu Kush, reading George MacDonald Fraser Flashman on the Afghans and the Afghan society makes more sense than reading Three Cups of Tea or any of that. As a writer, I mean, the reason I mention him as an influence on the writer, he's beautifully specific. His ear for 19th century vernacular English is marvelous, and his eye for detail is brilliant. And just to go back to my little riff when I was talking about ballet in the previous hour, you know, the terrible thing, Peter, is, I'm not a great one for, you know, teaching writing. All I think it's very hard to teach, but I do believe that. The deeper you can dig, you don't say the guy climbed into a car and drove away. It's better to identify what kind of car it is. And what I love about George MacDonald Fraser is he's dealing with something several generations removed from his own time, and yet the detail in the books is absolutely beautiful.